This is part 7 of solving linear equations. We're just going to continue working on these. So here's another problem. 3/5 x minus 14 equals negative 8. There are two ways to do this. You could first add 14 to both sides so that you isolate the x. Or, since it's an equation that has a fraction, you can multiply by the least common denominator and get rid of the fractions in the first step. So I'm going to do it both ways. So first step, we're going to add 14 to both sides. Remember the golden rule, as I called it in part 6, you can add the same thing to both sides, subtract, multiply, or divide, as long as it's not you're multiplying or dividing by 0, and still get the same solutions. So we have 3/5 x equals negative 8. I'm sorry, equals 6, because I have to remember negative 8 plus 14. All right, now we have 3/5 times x. So we could divide by 3/5, right? But it's easier to multiply by the reciprocal. The whole idea is if you multiply by the reciprocal here, then it will cancel. So the reciprocal is 5/3. But if you do it to one side, you also need to do it to the other side. So those cancel, those cancel, those cancel, which gives you 1x, or x, which is what we want. And now over here, we see if we can cancel. Now, if you want, you could think of that as 6 over 1, and cancel, and I get the answer of 10. All right, so that's the method of first adding 14. Okay, now we want to contrast that with, how about if I had 3/5 x minus 14 equals negative 8. How about if I multiplied both sides by the least common denominator, which is 5. So I have to multiply the left-hand side of the equation and the right-hand side of the equation by 5. If you want, you could put this in parentheses. How about making this red? All right, so we're multiplying both sides by negative 5. So we have to do the distributive property on the left, 5 over 1 times 3/5 x minus, and I'm just going to write that as 5, which is the same thing as 5 times 1, times 14. And 5 times negative 8 is negative 40. So on the left here, you can cancel the 5s, and that gives you 3x minus 70 equals negative 40. Now, some people could do this without showing all the steps and get 3x minus 70. That's fine. In other words, if you can do the distributive property and cancel on your head, okay, that's fine. Just make sure that you're accurate. All right, so now we don't have any fractions. So I could add 70 to both sides to now isolate the 3x, which is not a fraction. So I'm going to add 70 to both sides. And that gives me 3x equals 30, because negative 40 plus 70 is 30. And now we could divide both sides by 3. So we know that what 1x equals, and get our answer of x equals 10. So there's two methods. Now at the moment, it may seem like this method on the right takes more steps, and it does, actually. But there are other problems where there are more than one fraction, and in those cases, almost always it's easier to multiply both sides by the least common denominator. So we'll be seeing that in a minute. Okay, let's go ahead and check the problem over here on the left. So we're going to check. So we write out the original problem. Make sure that when you check a problem, you always write down the original problem, not some intermediate step like 3x minus 70 equals negative 40. And let's put in 10 for x. So we have 3/5 times 10. So I'm going to write that as 10 over 1 minus 14. And if I cancel, the 5 goes into the 10 too, so that gives me 6 minus 14. Well, that's 6 plus negative 14, which is negative 8. Now, on the right-hand side, there's nothing to plug in for x, so the answer is just negative 8, and there you go. So the answer is x equals 10, so you could just write the answer as 10, or you could write it using the solution braces. Okay, here's another problem. Notice this time I have, more than one fraction. So you could first subtract 1 from both sides, but then you would have to get a common denominator over here, etc. In this type of problem, especially when there's a fraction in more than one place, especially if it's for one of the constants, this is a constant, negative 1/3, it is easier to multiply by the least common denominator. So if we look at the denominators, I have a denominator of 3 and 9. The least common denominator is 9. So I want to multiply both sides of the equation by 9. So sometimes I do this to say, hey, I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 9. So I'm going to distribute it to every single term. An intermediate step is to write 9 times 1 minus 2/9 x and 9 times negative 1/3. All right, and then do the distributive property. So I have 9 times 1 minus 9 times 2/9 x equals, now 9 times negative 1/3, we could simplify that. 3 goes into 9 3 times, but I have it times a negative 1, so that's going to be negative 3. And over here we've got 9 minus 2x, because the 9's cancel, right? Which is why we multiply by the least common denominator, is to get rid of all fractions. This is called clearing fractions, clearing the denominator. And so we get 9 minus 2x is negative 3. Okay, next step. We need to isolate this negative 2x. Remember, it's not plus 2x, it's negative 2x. So let's first subtract 9 from both sides. So we isolate the negative 2x. Don't forget to write your minus sign. This is where a lot of people have problems. They just ignore negative signs. It's like you don't see them. Just kind of don't pay attention. Don't be careful. But oh, the devil is in those details. So we have negative 3 plus negative 9. Remember, that's negative 3 plus negative 9. That's negative 12. And now we would divide both sides by negative 2. So finally, we get x equals 6. Okay. Now, it's true that this could have been done very differently, and I'm going to do that next, but let's just check this first. All right, over here. Check. Is 1 minus 2/9 x equals negative 1/3. So we are going to put in positive 6 for x. And we're going to simplify. So we have 1 minus, all right, what happens here? Between the 6 and the 9, you can cancel. 3 goes into both of those numbers, 2 and 3. So this becomes, careful, in the numerator, 2 times 2, which is 4/3. Hopefully you all see that. And now how do you do 1 minus 4/3? We need a common denominator. So let's write 1 is 3/3 minus 4/3. And that way we do 3 minus 4 will be the new numerator, which is negative 1/3. On the right-hand side, that's what we have, negative 1/3. So it does check. So it looks like x equals 6 is the correct answer. All right, I'm going to go over the exact same problem, but what we're going to do is not multiply by the least common denominator. So we have 1 minus 2/9 x equals negative 1/3. So we have 1 minus 2/9 x equals negative 1/3. All right, so we're cute. Let's see. All right, so I could subtract 1 from both sides. But here's where you got to be careful. Again, this is negative 2/9 x. And on the right-hand side, how do you do negative 1/3 minus 1? Well, you better go over on the right-hand side and do this correctly. Negative 1 is the same as negative 3/3. So you have to get a common denominator. So that's going to be, when you add it up, negative 4/3. So you have to be careful getting common denominators, adding, etc. There's a little bit more work with the fractions if you don't multiply by the least common denominator. Now I need to multiply by the reciprocal of negative 2 ninths so that I just get 1x. So remember, if this is a negative, then the reciprocal is also going to be negative. So I'd multiply both sides by negative 9 halves. And on the left side, everything cancels, so it's 1x. That's great. So we get x equals. And on the right-hand side, you could either multiply and get 36, 6 and get 6, or you could cancel to get the answer of 6. So you could either just multiply it out. You see how negative times a negative is positive, and you get 36, 6, and then cancel. Or you can go ahead and do your regular canceling. 2 into 4 is 2. 3 into 9 is 3, and get 6 that way. So that's the answer, and we already checked it. So pay attention to these and decide if you like multiplying by the least common denominator or not. I hope you learned something. Remember,